Welcome to Chalk Talk, Danville Public Schools Weekly News Magazine. I'm Diane Locker, your host. This week we're at Galileo Magnet High School, and we're here to talk with Jared Smith, who's the history, isn't it, Jared?
Yes.
History teacher here. But we're here to mainly talk about his role with the Scholastic team. Now, I call it the Scholastic team. Jared, you say Scholastic Bowl Team?
Within the Virginia High School League, it is known as Scholastic Bowl, although it has a variety of names. Locally, people refer to it as ACE, which is an acronym, Academic Competition for Excellence. But in terms of state VHSL-sponsored competitions, it's referred to as Scholastic Bowl.
Now, you threw out an acronym there, VH. Yeah. It means the Virginia High School League, right?
Yes, ma'am.
That's all the schools in the state?
Yes. That's all public schools in the state who are classified currently into six classifications based on school populations. Galileo participates in classification 1A, since it is a small high school. 1A classification is subdivided then into two regions, a 1A East and a 1A West. With our geographic position in Southside, Virginia, we are part of the 1A East classification. And that regional subdivision is further divided into individual conferences.
Boy, that's almost more than I can take in there. Let me ask you this. Kind of cut this down to when you went to your first competition, mm-hmm. I believe you came in second place there. Mm-hmm. What other areas were in? What other counties, cities compete against?
Sure. Well, locally, we are fortunate in that we play in a district. Now, used to be with activities as well as athletics, district seasons, a champion and runner-up would then advance to the regional level, and from the region tournament, you would have a region champion and runner-up advance to a state tournament. Since the classifications went from like 1A, 2A, 3A to 1A through 6A, districts don't really account for nothing other than just regular season play. So locally, we compete in what's referred to as the old Dogwood District. Some of the schools we compete against are Alta Vista and William Campbell. Those are also in our conference, which is that kind of bottom tier of this new classification system. We also compete with Dan River, Appomattox, Gretna, Chatham High School, just to name a few. In addition, we may play some other schools locally, such as GW in our school division at a couple of tournaments we've played in. We've competed against Martinsville, competed against Bassett.
Now, this Virginia yes. High School League, is this the same one that is the athletic league also?
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what I want to talk about a little bit, about the type of competition that you and I have been talking about.
Sure.
This is, I think, kind of exciting because it's academics. It's not athletics, but it's structured somewhat like mm-hmm. athletics. Mm-hmm. Now, the competition, and these are called here at Galileo the Scholastic Bowl Team. Mm-hmm. The competition is called the Scholastic Bowl?
Yes, it's called the Scholastic Bowl, which is the Virginia High School League's oldest non-athletic activity in which a large number of schools participate in. Since about 1997, all state competitions are held upon the grounds of the College of William & Mary in Williamsburg. But it's just referred to as Scholastic Bowl, and you have a series of meets to dictate who advances to the state championship.
Same as athletics, playoff, playoff each other. And
mm-hmm.
you don't go to the next step until you win or place in the first step.
You play in advance.
Right. So. What I'd like for you to do now before we go any further is tell me how the game is played. Now, I've always looked at it, and we've done shows in the past, I've always looked at it as kind of like Jeopardy.
Yeah, that's a fair statement.
So tell me, if I went to one of these Scholastic Bowl competitions, what would I see? How is it structured?
Okay. Like any athletic event, there is a team of which you can make substitutions. There are periods to this. Scholastic Bowl is structured in a sense that you've got three individual rounds within what's called a match.
The first... Is that sort of like the quarters in a football game?
Sure, okay. Definitely. The first round and the third round are your toss-up rounds, your buzzers like you see in Jeopardy. Those consist of 15 questions. Those 15 questions cover anything from current events to pop culture to history, English, science, classics, languages, and so forth.
Now, the students that I'm going to be talking to later on in the show, each of these students has some specialty mm-hmm. in those areas that you were just talking
Certainly.
About.
Yes, we're fortunate to have replaced a very senior heavy squad from a year ago that put us on the map in terms of success with going to the state tournament last year. And
you were almost all seniors last year, weren't you?
Definitely. And we kind of grew that this year. We were a very young team. We only had two seniors this year, Captain Matty Ensminger and co-captain Nick Matherly.
But saying that, and that you've got a young team, now maybe my memory's not right. You scored better this year in competition than you did last year.
We did. With all due respect to a team from a year ago, I think the deciding factor between last year's senior heavy squad and this year's very youthful squad was that in terms of confidence, if kids on this year's team missed questions, it did not rattle them. With all due respect, it is a lot of pressure on you when you're competing against another school and there are people in the room and they're judging you based on what you say. There's a lot of weight there to make sure you understand the right answer. We were joking, Lane Larson, one of my juniors that's fast on the buzzer, we kind of joke with him on the team. We call him the Neg King because
what?
The Neg King for negative points.
Okay.
A lot of times he'll buzz in and he plays so aggressive that he misses the question and we're penalized for it. So we have to overcome that deficiency. But Lane, the strength of that is, for all the questions he gets wrong, he gets two or three others right upon the first clue that's red. So that's a significant advantage for us compared to other schools.
Do you know what I'm going to do?
Yeah.
What I'm going to do now is I'm going to get Lane up here and talk to him and see what he says about this fast buzzer stuff. And then I'm going to get back with you.
Sure.
Earlier when we talked about the game, we talked about the speed that's required. I have the two speed demons here with me. And Mr. Smith told me these are the ones that are really fast on the button. I have Henry Stevens and Lane Larson with me. Now, Henry, what's your grade level?
I'm 11th grade.
How many years have you been on the team?
I've only been on 3 years now, I think.
3 years? That's a long time. Okay. How about you? How long have you been on the team?
Just for 2 years.
2 years. Now, what's your grade level?
11th as well.
You're 11th. Okay. So you've got one more year.
Yes.
All right. The game is like Jeopardy. It's the way I've always thought of it.
Sure.
All right. Have you ever hit the button and not known the answer?
I have done that many times. Yes.
I keep thinking about it, it's almost like a speed thing, isn't it, to hit that button and get in before the other team does it?
Mm-hmm.
So tell me about a time you hit it and you didn't have the answer. What do you do?
Well,
say I'm sorry.
The first thing you do is you think about it while you're trying to answer. So you sort of take a little longer to put out the answer. You think about all your options, because when we play, I think Lane does the same thing that I do. You come up with an idea of what you are thinking the answer is, even if you aren't quite sure exactly what it is. So you kind of have an idea what the question is looking for, and then you try and finish the problem while you're buzzing it.
What's your area of specialty?
I'm a literature person.
Now, that's kind of broad. Tell me what that means. What kind of questions might you answer or get thrown at you?
Well, we have some questions on people like Pearl Buck, Thomas Mann. Yeah, authors. Also have works like The Inferno. That was actually one that we missed right at the end of States. But
see, you always remember the things you do wrong. Mm-hmm. See? You missed that one, so you remember. Now, I also heard that you do current events?
Yes, everybody on the team is up to date on current events. We're kind of living through all of them ourselves.
Okay.
So
give me an example of a current event.
There were a few Donald Trump questions.
Yep. I'm going to let that one go so that, because that could go on forever here. Lane, what's your area?
More like history and classical music and like science, physics, and stuff.
Let me ask you the same thing I asked Henry. Ever hit that button and not have the answer?
Yes, I have done that many times. Usually,
how do you get out of it? It sounds like he kind of talks his way in, waiting for his brain to kind of kick in on the answer.
I'm probably a little less effective player. I usually just say, I like groan and sigh, say sorry to my team, and then offer some answer that really has nothing to do with what it's looking for. So yeah. I just accept the negative and then just keep moving on.
If you do hit a buzzer, maybe too soon, does that default to the other team?
Yeah, so after we hit the buzzer and get it wrong, we can't answer for the rest of the question, and the other team gets a free answer.
Okay,
so
that's what I said.
Plus the negative points that we get, -5 for buzzing incorrectly.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
I didn't realize that they took the points off for that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's -5 points for getting it incorrect. But interrupting. If you don't interrupt, then there's no negative.
Give me a sample of a question that might come to you on history or classical music, something like that.
They ask a lot of classical music, like composers or certain like operas that they've written. Or in history, there's lots of United States history, like this president or this administration. And they'd give different clues about what a president has done in their office, and then you would know who it is.
How long? Go ahead.
They seem to love the Battle of Hastings.
They do. That's definitely different history, but
I'm glad they do, because I don't think I know what it is. Now, how many years have you been on the team?
Just two. My second year.
No. Next year, you're a senior.
Yes.
What are your ultimate plans after you get out of school?
Out of high school?
Yes.
I go to college and get a degree.
In what?
This is what I don't know yet.
Okay. I'll let you get away with that. Yeah. How about you? Well, after you get out, you get senior next year. What's your plans after that?
Well, one day I want to write, so it's probably good that I'm a literature person. I don't really know, though, so I guess going to college is involved there somehow.
Do you write now?
A little bit. Nothing worth mentioning.
Then I won't ask you. Thanks for talking to me, both of you.
No problem. Thank you.
We're going to take a short break now. Be sure and come back after the break, because what we want to do is we want to talk with some more students about the competition.
Hello, my name is J.D. Edmonds, and this is my wife,
Janine Edmonds.
I am the Bonner Booster President, and I'm encouraging all you parents to get involved with your child's education, get involved with the community, and show your support for your kid's school.
Continue to be that bridge between the community, school, and family.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, I'm at Galileo Magnet High School, and we're here to talk with the Scholastic Bowl team. And I have two of the students here with me now. In the first half of the show, we talked with some of the students, and we also talked with Mr. Smith about the competition. I have Kiki with me and William. Now, Kiki, what's your grade level?
I'm a ninth grader.
I heard that you were a freshman. This is your first time on the team, but I heard you had a brother, who I think I interviewed last year, who was on the team and was one of those really good ones. You've got something to live up to.
I do. I'm working on it and getting there.
Now, what's your area?
I don't have one yet. I just pick up little pieces that other people might not know.
Well, then that's harder, because then you cover all of the areas?
Not really. I don't play as much as other people, because I'm just a ninth grader and I haven't taken the classes that other people have. But when I do play, I can pick up things that other people might not think about.
Have you had a chance to hit the buzzer yet?
Yes.
What's it like?
It's pretty nice, but it's also a bit nerve-wracking.
It would be totally nerve-wracking for me. Now, William?
Yes.
You are the history expert?
Well, not expert, but yes, I like history a lot.
Now, you had another area you do too, don't you?
Mythology. The whole Greek gods and goddesses and that kind of stuff.
Oh, okay. I was going to ask you what made up mythology, but I think that kind of covered it.
Not just Greek gods and goddesses, also stuff on different mythologies, Norse mythology. I believe one time we had Japanese and stuff like that. It's basically stuff from old religions that that's like Greece and Rome and Norse. Yeah,
a lot of that old stuff.
Yes.
Okay. Now, how long have you been on the team?
First year as well.
First year?
Yeah.
What made you decide to get on the team?
I could say that I've always wanted to be part of Ace, but Henry and Lane kind of made me, and I've been here, and it's fun.
All right. What about competition? What do you think is the hardest thing about competing?
Sitting on the sidelines and then knowing an answer, but the people who are up there don't know the answer, and you're sitting there in anguish. Just,
that hurts.
Yeah, it hurts a lot. Because like, if I was just up there, I could answer. But no, you're not, and you have to wait until either they don't get the question or someone else on the other team gets it, and you're like, ah!
That's sort of like being the parent at the Little League game, trying to tell the kids what to do. Now, how many people are on the team?
Well, on the people who usually play, about 10 or 8. But there's how many? Like 20? Yeah.
But if you're sitting on the sidelines when any game is being played, or however it's played, any section of the game, half of the game, how many people are up there actually playing if you're sitting on the sidelines?
Usually there's 4 people up there, and it's just 4 people, and a bunch of people are back and sitting.
Dude, I asked someone a little bit earlier about how do you know what they're going to ask? What's the range of what they're going to ask? Do they say bring your history majors up, your math majors, or just you go up and it's potluck for what?
It's potluck. They don't usually the first period can be about anything. The second period as well, but there's math questions entered in the directed round, and that's where Krush comes in. And then the third period is basically the first period, and the questions could be about anything. So usually you like to have an range of people, so it helps balance out.
Now, did I ask you what your grade level was? I don't think so.
I am 10th, sophomore.
You're 10th. So you have any idea what you want to do after high school?
No. No idea. Thought about
you didn't have to even think about that. You just said no idea.
I have no idea. I've honestly tried to think about it.
You've got 2 years to make up your mind. Now, I'm not going to ask you what you're going to do after high school, but you probably already know, don't you?
I do not. I'm going to go to college, I think, but sometimes I'll go through a few months where I think I'll want to go into a particular field, but then I'll rethink it and change.
You've got time. You've got time. Thanks for talking to me. Thank you.
Thank you.
I have Maddie Esminger and Nick Matherly with me now, and they are, let's say, the captains of the team. We have captain number one and assistant captain. Is that a way to put it?
Co-captain.
Okay. We like that. All right. What do we need the captain for? What is it that you do for the team in your capacity as captain?
I think my best capacity as captain is really organizing the team and getting everyone to specialize in a specific area of questioning. Making sure people show up to practice, making sure people are reviewing study materials, making sure that we have different subject areas covered by different players on the team.
Now, speaking of getting people to show up, now you are perfect attendance show up, correct?
Yes, I like to try to set an example for some of the younger members on the team, and so I show up for practice, and I come to perform every time that the ACE team needs me. And I think in that way that I encourage younger members of the team to also come to practice and put a lot of effort into their time here.
Now, how long have you been on the team?
I've been on the team 2 years, but I participated in the GW ACE team for a year during my freshman year of high school. So I've been on ACE for 3 years, but I've only been with Galileo for 2.
What's your area?
I honestly do a little bit of everything.
I'm always in awe of smart people, but smart in everything, just...
Well, I wouldn't say smart in everything. I just kind of tie in the loose ends. Like, I pick up a lot of religion and mythology questions, as well as the biology questions. I have a particular interest in biology, and so I tend to pick up a lot of those questions. But yeah, I just kind of cover the areas that, you know, our other strong players may not necessarily have being specialized.
Involved in all of it.
Yeah.
What's your area?
I do science and classical music.
Someone else I was just talking to, Lane Larson, also does classical music. So people aren't specialized to the point that someone else isn't in your area. Is that a correct statement?
Yeah, he didn't really study for the classical music. That was just stuff. He's played piano for quite a while. But what I did is I got like a list of 90-ish composers and worked on memorizing their most famous works and familiarizing myself with their operas and stuff like that.
When you get ready to go to a competition, do you have, when you said you looked at 90 people, do you have any idea what they're going to cover? Do they give you this is a beginning and this is an end, it could be anything in the middle? It can just be anything in that subject area. Mm-hmm. Now, I talked a little bit with some of them about the buzzer situation. I'm the type of person that if you time me, even on computer games, when they have those little bombs that'll explode in a couple of seconds, throws me off completely. How do you deal with that?
I'm always a little hesitant on the buzzers. I'm not as fast as Henry and Lane, so it takes me a little while. It's a little stressful, but I usually try to wait until I'm completely positive that I know the answer before I buzz in.
So you don't get the negative points.
Yeah, I don't get the negatives.
Now, you're graduating this year. What happens next year?
I'm planning on going to college and getting a dual major in botany and chemistry.
You are going to be busy and studying hard. Yeah. Now, what's happening to you next year? Because you graduate this year.
Next year, I'd like to pursue a major in biotechnology and eventually get my PhD in genetics.
I'm just surrounded by all these smart people. Thank you for talking to me.
Thank you.
Mr. Smith told me that he had an absolute math genius here and someone that absolutely loves math. And here he is right here, Kush Patel. Now, the unusual thing about Kush Patel is Kush just came here, from India. Now, Kush, how long have you been here?
Like 8 or 9 months. My 1 year completes in April.
That's amazing. Now, this love of math, you must be the math guru on the team.
Yeah.
Now, where does this come from, this love of math?
From my home country. It's like my teachers from that country made me love math. Like, people were scared of the math in that country, but I loved math.
Let me tell you something. I live right here, and I don't love math. I'm afraid of it, like some of the people you're talking about. Mm-hmm. Now, what brought you to America?
My family, like the education, first of all, and then my family, my father's side family is all in America, so I followed them here. And the education, like, attracted me.
Well, we are glad to have you, and we're especially glad to have you on the Scholastic Bowl team. Now, tell me about competition. Have you ever experienced anything like that in India, or was this your first time on something like this?
I have practiced in some of the quizzes in India, but it's nothing like this. This is on a very high-level thing. This is very important and very much difficult.
Now, you're a junior now.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you're going to come back to the Scholastic team next year?
Yeah, obviously. I will come on this team next year, and our goal, I will try to contribute in our goal to win the states next year.
Now, you'll be a senior next year, and then you'll graduate. What do you want to do after you graduate? Something in math?
Obviously, math major. I want to go for math major, and also, I'm not decided, but I also want to do kind of a physics double major with math, but math is my first choice.
That's great. I want you to know we are glad to have you here in America and especially glad to have you here at Galileo. Come back next year, and you got to do what you said you were going to do about pushing the team. We're second this year. We want to be number one next year.
Mm-hmm. And I will contribute to that.
Okay. Thank you. Jared.
Yes.
I can't tell you how neat it was to talk with these students. Mm-hmm. I mean, they point up everything that you said in the beginning of the show, mm-hmm. about how that buzzer. And I loved talking to Lane, and he did tell me that he did get the negative points. Mm-hmm. He said that he hit that buzzer so fast. Now, what are you holding in front of you here? Now, I know you came in a competition early this year. You came in second. What is this for?
Well, this was a year of seconds, which is to be expected with such a young squad. What I'm holding here is the Virginia High School League Scholastic Bowl State Runner-Up or Second Place Trophy. We were second in the state this year behind Honaker, which is from the western regions of the state, or the Commonwealth, rather. They won the state championship a year ago as well as this year, so they went back-to-back.
Now, let me ask you something. We've done this, we've interviewed and talked about sure. this for several years.
Sure.
Is this the first time you've gotten this far?
It's our highest end-of-the-season placement we've been able to obtain. A year ago, we were fourth in the state. So we improved with a much younger squad. And
That's great.
Most of that is due to the person who is the backbone of our team, Henry Stevens, my literature guru. He has been a phenomenal asset to our team this year, and we're excited about having him and Lane. And in addition to that, our math guy, really the math guru himself, Kush Patel, back.
I was so impressed when I talked with Kush, because you're talking to someone that's learning a whole new culture.
Yeah.
Along with
yeah.
Getting involved in,
sure.
in games like this.
Sure. Well, you know, he's just he's a good kid, and he's a pleasure to be around. We have a lot of fun with him. He's actually kind of tutored Henry and Will and some other of my kind of mythology interested people on Hinduism, and we've been able to pick up a couple of questions on that from just his kind of cultural experiences.
I didn't even think about that.
So,
the
yeah.
culture he brought
yeah.
with
yeah.
him fit right
yeah.
in.
Yeah.
Now,
so.
Let me ask you quick before we have to leave. I know you are the sponsor or contact for this group, mm-hmm. but aren't all of the teachers involved?
Yes. I'm just the kind of measly coach. All I do is run the practices and go to the tournaments and, you know, stay with the kids and whatnot. But, you know, the success of the team is very much Galileo-driven. That's a testament to the teachers here. And the job they do each day inside the classroom. To prepare my kids for postseason play, including the state tournament, we weekly would have teacher versus student scrimmages that would go on for about 45 minutes after school. And we would kind of flip-flop. 1 week the kids would win, 1 week the teachers would win. And it was very competitive. And it's one of those things that I suppose if you were a 17, 18-year-old kid, you don't know what to expect being pushed from somebody who is competent and almost a mastery-level knowledge of what they're teaching. So it really forces those kids to be on their A game. And, you know, when they beat us, that was a sense of accomplishment for them.
What a great way for them to
yeah.
to learn
yeah.
about all of this,
yeah.
to learn the competition, and
yeah.
and they probably really wanted to beat their teachers.
Most definitely. So,
well, I want to congratulate you.
Thank you.
And talking to these students was great. They're all great, and they look like a fun group to work with. They
definitely.
Had and the confidence that you talked about in the beginning of this young group, mm-hmm. definite. The confidence was there in each one of them that I talked to.
Oh, most definitely.
Yeah.
They are very confident group, and that's only going to grow. And you know, next year we're going to have a very senior heavy squad with Henry and Lane and Kush back.
Well, then I'm expecting to come back, and this is going to be first place.
Well, those are my expectations as well,
because Kush told me he was going to make it first.
Oh, he's got a goal, and
yeah.
and we're driven, and it's noticeable, and I'm very proud of these guys. I know the entire school is proud of them. So we've got a youthful bunch that, hey, we can ride this thing out for a couple more years. So,
well, congratulations. Yeah. Congratulations. Thanks for all the hard work you do. Want to thank all of you for being with us this week, and we're so proud of these kids and the work that they're doing. Be sure to come back next week and see what we're doing in Danville Public Schools.